you went crazy on this bitch.
What we have here is your garden variety 2012 Jeep Liberty
KK
Limited 4x4. Another vehicle in the lineup. This is the daily workhorse. Day to day, get things done. Pretty clean, 129,000 miles. Fully loaded everything. Got it for a pretty good steal a couple years ago. Been real good to me. Only problem I've had so far is the air conditioner box that sits in the middle of the dash. The left side has a bunch of gears and levers on it that popped off kind of loose and wouldn't let the air change to vent. It would stay on defrost all the time. And anyway, bought another box, like $100. Took the things off the side. Didn't replace the box because that requires taking out the whole dash. All the interior, the dash, everything. So we just replaced the gears and levers. Got it working good. But anyway, step one, you want one of these. It's a plastic trim rivet remover. It's become very invaluable to me. We keep this in the toolbox at all times. Pretty much keep it in every car at all times. Comes with a, you can get it from Amazon. Comes with a box like 200 different fasteners for whatever you end up doing. You're gonna break them, take them off. But anyway.
Tab first and then go under. Now this is also what you're gonna have to do when it's time to change the oil filter. This oil filter is a beast. I think it's pretty much just a hard problem on the 4x4, not on the regular two buys and whatnot. Because they got some little blockages in here that won't let you just reach in. All the way down underneath the bank of cylinders. Hard to get to. Anyway, once you got all those off, I'm gonna go ahead and unclip the clip there. You also gotta pop these up and around. But you know what? We're gonna remove all of them first. Not just the ones on the actual grill have to also come up. It all comes out as one piece. I usually should leave these somewhere. I'll leave them all up there for now. That. You also got the hood latch cable. Now, time to do the headlight. What you need for this is a Torx 20. You got it right here. Got a box of them that I got off of Amazon. Cheap, cheap, cheap. Got everything you need, all the Torx you need. Especially when dealing with these American cars that use Torx bits. But anyway, we got three screws keeping the headlight in. Easy breezy. Here. One here, it's already loose. Look at that. Unlike the LXs or the WKs, you don't have to dig all up under the bumper to get these things off. This is just so super cool. Now, got a couple of connections here to deal with. We've already did a sort of a LED light upgrade, but it plugged right into the factory harness. So I'll just slide the little red part down, get rid of that. And down here, you want to pull out the fog light bulb. Now this is the only way to get to this fog light bulb. You gotta pull the whole headlight out, grill, headlight, everything you got to do. You will never be able to reach it and get it in there right. Because actually, I had a hard time getting in an LED bulb in here because this was so tight. So I had to loosen these, put the bulb in, set it, and then tighten them back down. You'll never be able to do that while it's in the car. Can't do it. At least I can't. Anyway, this headlight's off.
Both lights are off. We're ready to get back in business. But this is the point where you get when you want to change your oil pump. Now you got the vehicle up, oil's drained. Coming down here is not an issue. Can't even see it. Oil pump has to be reached in here. See it? There it is, mobile one. You have to, by hand, get this headlight off so you can get in there, do what you gotta do. We just did oil change, so I'm not gonna do it right now, but that is the way to go.
For future reference, another tip for your Uncle Willie.